My dear loving students, now I want to solve problem number 7 of the NCERT and problem number 7 of study material also. Problem is x by root over x square plus 1, x minus 1. What do you observe? We observe that in the denominator, x square plus 1 is a quadratic expression and x minus 1 is a linear factor. So we hear how you split, how you write x, it is an important point. So one factor is quadratic, so you write x plus b by x square plus 1. Other factor is linear, so we will write c by x minus 1. By comparing the coefficient of like terms, now we can find the value of a, b and c. Now x plus b into x minus 1 and c into x square plus 1. It will be x square minus x plus bx minus b, cx square plus c. Taking x square common, it will be a plus c. Taking x common, it will be b minus a plus c minus b. Equating the coefficient of like terms, b minus a is equal to 1, a plus c is equal to 0, c minus b is equal to 0. So now we have c is equal to b. Also b minus a is equal to 1, a plus b is equal to 0. Adding, we will get 2b is equal to 1, b is equal to half, c is equal to half, and now we can find the value of a is equal to minus 1 by 2. So now, my dear student, we write x square plus 1 into x minus 1 minus half x plus half divided by x square plus 1 plus half x minus 1 integration x by x square plus 1 x minus 1 dx minus half x by x square plus 1 dx half 1 by x square plus 1 dx half 1 by x minus 1 dx. So my dear student, I1 is equal to minus half x by x square plus 1. Now we do some arrangement here. So we multiply numerator and denominator by 2 so that in the numerator it will be the differential coefficient of denominator. So my dear student, x square plus 1 is equal to t, 2x dx is equal to dt. So now it can be written as minus 1 by 4 dt by t. Minus 1 by 4 log mod t plus c1. I1 is equal to minus 1 by 4 log x square plus 1 plus c1. Similarly, I2 is equal to half 1 by 1 plus x square dx. And I2 is equal to half tan inverse x plus c2. I3 is equal to half 1 by x minus 1 dx. So I3 is equal to half log x minus 1 plus c3. So now, my dear student, it will be x divided by x square plus 1 x minus 1 dx minus 1 by 4 log x square plus 1 half tan inverse x 1 by 2 log mod minus x1 c1 c2 c3 is equal to c. So finally we have x by x square plus 1 x minus 1 dx minus 1 by 4 log x square plus 1 half tan inverse x half log mod x minus 1 plus c. Now my dear student, we want to solve problem number 8, x by x minus 1 whole square x plus 2 dx. So it is on the formula a x minus 1 whole square x plus 2. So it is a by x minus 1 plus b by x minus 1 whole square plus c by x plus 2. Now we can write x in this form. So after simplification we have a into x minus 1 into x plus 2, b into x plus 2 plus c into x minus 1 whole square. So now it will be a x square 2x minus x minus 2, b x plus 2, c x square minus 2x plus 1. Now taking ax square plus 2x minus ax minus 2a, bx plus 2b, x square minus 2x plus 1 into c. So by comparing coefficient of like term, we have x is equal to x square a plus c, ax plus bx minus 2cx माइनस टू ए प्लस टू बी प्लस सी. सो एक्स इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर ए प्लस सी. ए प्लस बी माइनस टू सी इंटू एक्स. टू बी माइनस टू ए प्लस सी. इक्वेटिंग कोफिशियंट ऑफ लाइक टर्म्स वी हैव ए प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो. ए प्लस बी माइनस टू सी इक्वल टू वन. टू बी माइनस टू ए प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो. एंड आफ्टर सिंप्लीफाइंग वी हैव ए प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो. सी इक्वल टू माइनस ए. ए प्लस बी माइनस टू माइनस ए इक्वल टू वन. ए प्लस बी प्लस टू ए इक्वल टू वन. थ्री ए प्लस बी इक्वल टू वन. फ्रॉम सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ वी हैव सी इक्वल टू माइनस ए. टू बी माइनस टू ए माइनस ए. टू बी माइनस थ्री ए इक्वल टू जीरो. एडिंग फाइव एंड सिक्स वी हैव बी इक्वल टू वन बाई थ्री. पुटिंग बी इक्वल टू वन बाई थ्री इन फाइव वी गेट थ्री ए प्लस बी इक्वल टू वन. थ्री ए प्लस वन बाय थ्री प्लस वन. थ्री ए इक्वल टू वन माइनस वन बाई थ्री. एंड ए इक्वल टू टू बाई नाइन. ए प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो. टू बाई नाइन प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो. सी इक्वल टू माइनस टू बाई नाइन. सो नाउ पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स बाय एक्स माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर एक्स प्लस टू डी एक्स. ए बाय एक्स माइनस वन डी एक्स. बी बाय एक्स माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर. एंड सी बाय एक्स प्लस टू डी एक्स. सो टू बाय नाइन डी एक्स बाय एक्स माइनस वन. वन बाय थ्री डी एक्स एक्स माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर. माइनस टू बाय नाइन डी एक्स बाय एक्स प्लस टू. सो आई वन इजक्वल टू ट्वाइस बाय नाइन लॉग मॉड एक्स माइनस वन सी वन. आई थ्री इजक्वल टू माइनस ट्वाइस नाइन लॉग एक्स प्लस टू सी थ्री. नाउ हाउ यू इंटीग्रेट I2. 1 by 3 dx x minus 1 whole square. Let x minus 1 is equal to t. dx is equal to dt. So 1 by 3 dt by t square. 1 by 3 t to the power minus t dt. T minus 2 plus 1 minus 2 plus 1 into 1 by 3 plus c2. 1 by 3 t to the power minus 1 minus 1 plus c2. Minus 1 by 3 t minus 1 plus c2. Minus 1 by 3 1 by x minus 1 plus c2. So x dx x minus 1 whole square into x plus 2 is equal to 2 by 9 log mod x minus 1 plus c1. Minus 1 by 3 x minus 1 c2. Minus 2 by 9 log mod x plus 2 c3. So my dear students, now it will be 2 by 9 log x minus 1 by x minus 2. Minus 1 by 3 x minus 1. And c1 plus c2 plus c3 is equal to c. In this way we can solve this problem. Now I want to solve next problem. Problem number 9 of NCRT. 3x plus 5x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 dx. My dear student, how will you solve this problem? First you factorize this polynomial. It will be x cube minus x square minus x plus 1. Putting p x equal to 1, we have 0. So 1 factor is x minus 1. Now we divide x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 by x minus 1. So it will be x square minus 1. So 3x plus 5 divided by x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 can be written as 3x plus 5 x square minus 1 into x minus 1. 3x plus 5, x minus 1, x plus 1, x minus 1. 3x plus 5, x minus 1 whole square, x plus 1. So 3x plus 5 divided by x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 dx is equal to 3x plus 5, x minus 1 whole square, x plus 1 dx. Proceed it as problem number 8 or similar to problem number 8. It is the question as we have discussed. The problem number 8. What is in problem number 8? One factor repeats. So here x minus 1 repeats. So in this way you can solve this problem. My dear students, now I want to solve problem number 10 of NCRT and problem number 11 of study material. 2x minus 3, x square minus 1, 2x plus 3. This can be written as 2x minus 3, x plus 1, x minus 1, 2x plus 3. My dear student, here there are 3 linear factors. How many linear factors? 3 linear factors. And all are non-repeating. So we can solve this problem as problem number 1. Now, problem number 11. 5x by x plus 1, x plus 2, x minus 2 dx. And it is also problem of this factor is linear, this factor is linear, this factor is linear and non-repeating. So we can solve this problem as we have solved problem number 1. It is similar to problem number 10 and 1 also. Now my dear student, next problem is problem number 12, x cube plus x plus 1 divided by x square minus 1 into dx. What do you observe? We observe that it is a x cube plus x plus 1. So it is not proper fraction. So we will divide numerator by the denominator to make it proper. So now it will be x, 2x plus 1, x square plus 1. What do you observe? 2x plus 1 by x square minus 1 can be written as 2x plus 1, x plus 1 into x minus 1. Now again we can solve this problem as we have solved problem number 1. Though we have solved it by applying the limiting matter to find the coefficient, the value of a and b. My dear student, now it can be written as a by x plus 1, b by x minus 1. So now we want to find a, we want to recall a is equal to limit, make x plus 1 is equal to 0, x tends to minus 1, limit x tends to minus 1, 2x plus 1 by x minus 1. And by putting x is equal to minus 1, we have a is equal to 1 by 2. B is equal to limit x tends to 1, 2x plus 1, x plus 1. By putting x is equal to 1, we get b is equal to 3 by 2. So x cube plus x plus 1, x square 1 minus dx is equal to x dx. Half x plus 1 dx. 3 by 2, 1 by x minus 1 dx. And it will be x square plus 2. It will be half log x plus 2. It will be 3 by 2 log x minus 1 plus c. In this way we can solve this problem. Now my dear student, we want to solve problem number 13 of NCERT. This is 2, 1 minus x, 1 plus x square. 2, 1 minus x, 1 plus x square can be written as, it is a quadratic fraction. It is a quadratic expression. So a by 1 minus x, it is linear, bx plus c by 1 plus x square. And we can solve this problem by finding the value of a, b and c. So here LCM is 1 minus x, 1 plus x square. And it will be a into 1 plus x square, bx plus c into 1 minus x. And after simplifying, we have 2 is equal to a into x square plus bx minus bx square minus cx plus c. Taking common x square, a minus b. Taking common c, x, b minus c. And it will be a plus c. Comparing the coefficient of like term. So a plus c is equal to 2, this is constant. A minus b, there is no term involving x square, so 0. There is no term involving x, so this is 0. So a minus c. 2a is equal to 2, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to 1. Now we can easily integrate 2 by 1 minus x, 1 plus x square dx, 1 by 1 minus x dx, plus x by 1 plus x square, plus 1 by 1 plus x square dx. So it will be minus 1 by x minus 1 dx, half 2x. We do here some arrangement, 2 multiply 2 and divide 2 to get differentiation of denominator, and that is 1 by 1 plus x square dx. So it will be minus log x minus 1, half log 1 plus x square and tan inverse x plus c. In this way we can solve this problem. Now problem number 14 of NCERT and problem number 13 of study material. It will be 3x minus 1 x plus 2 whole square, and it can be solved by writing it in this form and finding the value of n, a and b by comparing the coefficient of like term. My dear student, dx by x to the power 4 minus 1, and it can be written as x square minus 1 x plus 1. It can be written as x plus 1 x minus 1 x square plus 1. And now it can be splitted a by x plus 1, b by x minus 1, cx plus d by x square plus 1. My dear student, by comparing the coefficient of like terms, you can solve this problem. Priya vidyarthiyo, is jagah main aapse kahna chahunga. Yeh sawal kitab mein lamba dhang se banaya hai. Main isko short mein banane ka koshish kiya hu. Aap is method ko dekhiye. Yeh board mein aaya hai aur yeh bahut important hai. Dx by x to the power 4 minus 1 ka integration hum short method mein karna chahte hain. To dx by x to the power 4 minus 1, it can be written as x square minus 1 x plus 1. Now it can be rearranged. 1 by x square minus 1, 1 by x square plus 1. देखो, x square plus 1 minus x square minus 1. तो कट गया ऊपर में 2, 2 से भाग दे दी. Now half 1 by x square minus 1 dx minus half x square plus 1 dx. It is on the standard formula x square minus a square. The integration of x square minus a square dx is 1 by 2a log x minus 1 x plus 1. Here a is equal to 1. So we'll write half into half log x minus 1 mod x plus 1 minus half tan inverse x plus c. So it will be dx by x to the power 4 minus 1. 1 by 4 log x minus 1 by x plus 1 minus half tan inverse x plus c. My dear student, in this way we can solve this problem by another technique. So I hope you will do it. You will revise it and you will solve this problem by alternative methods. Now I will solve problem number 16. How will you solve this problem? I will discuss in next video. Thank you. Thank you very much.